Yeah, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, Chairman of the Board, Mr. Raza, good friend. It's really an honor for me to be here and have the chance to congratulate you personally for 50 years anniversary. I can inform you I'm always more than 50 years married, then you can see. Even after 50 years, something is still happening. And I'm very sure looking around here and seeing all those young faces, this will be a good chance for you indeed. Yes, it is clear that this is a very, very visionary approach. And being asked to mention some dimensions of a new development agenda, it is worth to ask what was the old one? And when did we start? And what is the change? And what is the consequence on the global level for that? And you see, being a little bit older, it's always good to say it was already in my time. Otherwise, in Germany, they always mention that the best ministers are the former ministers. Maybe in Austria, maybe others. And can inform you, we also had some elections. The time after the election is at least as interesting as the election before. Anyhow, if I go back, the question, what is our economic system doing with regard to other consequences, started very early with regard to the social dimensions. And we know that this was also linked with trade unions and other instruments and with legislation. On the global level, the question what is going on with environment was a wonderful other consequence of economic development. In Germany, Willy Brandt mentioned that he wanted to see the blue sky on the Ruhr district in the 60s. Only to give you a little bit of feeling that what is happening right now in China is not so surprising. If we had it until the 60s that we couldn't see the blue sky on the Ruhr district. And the first conference echoing to this consequence of economic development in the UN system was in 1972 in Stockholm. By the way, 20 minutes is very short. And you see, when you start with 1972, you have a problem to come to the reality, but I will hurry up. Therefore, I don't quote the speech of Indira Gandhi in 1972, and I recommend very strongly to all the young people, please do it. Go on the internet and read it. Wonderful. One sentence, which is to discuss very intensively right now, was poverty is the most toxic in the world. Is that still true? Or is affluent not even more toxic than poverty? Only to mention this, let's start. It was, by the way, a huge risk for the UN system because the developing countries tried to boycott this consequence. They came back and say, you guys, you made your economic development and now you overuse the nature and you come back and say, finish. It is something like a non-tarifferic trade barrier for you that you now start with environment topics. And it was really more than a good work of Maurice Strong in those days to overcome this. But the lesson was learned. And 20 years later, in 1992, in Rio, it was not the second United Nations Conference on the Human Environment. It was the United Nations Conference on Environment and Development. In those days, I was a younger minister. And you had not to quote all what I did in the meantime. By the way, it's always a risk to be awarded for your lifetime awards because that's a signal that you have to stop thinking, that don't want to do this. Anyhow, in those days I was a young minister and I was entitled to represent Germany in Rio, 1992. And we made tours around the world discussing with our friends the process, the expected results. The first question always to discuss was, is that the United Nations Conference on Environment and Development? Or is that the United Nations Conference on Development and Environment? In developing countries, it was absolutely clear that D was much more important than E. And that E has to be something like an instrument to overcome underdevelopment. So to make environment an instrument for handling this. As you see, in those days, it was still possible to make the majority in the world responsible for the title. It was Environment and Development. 10 years later, in Johannesburg, 2002, the title was already the United Nations Conference on Sustainable Development. So it was integrated, was the outcome from our friends in Rio de Janeiro. Surprisingly enough, in the year 2000, we discussed and decided on Millennium Development Goals. 8 years after the summit, we made sustainable development the target. I was a culprit. I was an undersecretary general in those days. And maybe I was not strong enough or stupid enough. We didn't make sustainable development, knowing that, of course, the idea that our lifestyle, our way of living is unquestioned, and we have only to give those information to the development world. It was from north to south thinking. And it was the south, in the preparation for Rio Plus 20, 2012 in Rio, asking, we don't want to have any longer Millennium Development Goals, but we want to give you the clear signal that you guys are making problems for us as well, and therefore we need Sustainable Development Goals. Because you are not sustainable at all, and the consequence of your lifestyle is a problem for us. That's what we call the externalization of our costs of living, and that is more than only a wording. So those Sustainable Development Goals have a very political connotation. Yes, they are universal, but why are they universal? And why was it Colombia and others asking for Sustainable Development Goals? Because they were fed up with the fact that those developed countries were convinced they can go on as they are, and they have to inform those and to take over their development model. I think this is nearly 20 minutes to consider. And therefore, this, you see, I'm one of those people who don't have a presentation. It's always difficult. You are invited, and then there come the telephone calls. Please send us already your presentation. Explain somebody that you only want to deliver a speech. It's very difficult, by the way, very difficult. So I'm not a shower. I have no presentation. And I don't want to start this. I stick to my kind of trying to concentrate your ears to my speech and not your eyes on something else. But they are wonderful presentations as well, no doubt. Wonderful, wonderful presentations, no doubt. So the outcome of Rio Plus 20 was the future we want. The future we want. And one topic in this was, let's discuss sustainable development goals. Hard discussion in Rio in those days. Had the chance to be there as well. And indeed, nearly a miracle, after a very short time, after 2012, we had this decision on the 17 goals and 169 targets. Some people after this came to the conclusion, aha, that is a clear signal, you don't want to do anything. 17 and 169, that's a signal, who can do it? And it was mentioned, yeah, we need the indicators, but for the indicators you need the data. I was responsible for UNEP headquartered in Nairobi in Kenya. And when I imagine that all those 169 targets have an indicator to quantify, I come to the conclusion it will be a very difficult topic. It will be a very difficult topic to come to something like monitoring. And nobody until now asked, how do we do that? If you go a little bit to the climate experience, and it's always good to learn from the appearings, we also started with Kyoto Protocol. The Kyoto Protocol was top-down. The criteria for success of a COP in climate was targets, timetables, means of implementation, and monitoring assessment. that was, if you couldn't come to this, disaster. The Copenhagen conference was criticized as the worst conference ever. Without Copenhagen, we never had changed our asset. Now we change it not from top down, but from bottom up, and we ask the countries, please give us your intended national determined contribution for the climate topic. We ask the nations. If I see this, I would strongly recommend, isn't that not necessary, again, to go bottom up? Can we come to something like intended national determined perspectives for the implementation of Agenda 2030? Can we come to something like a guiding process for development? Because the second topic after universality is integration. These 17 are heavily integrated. It is mentioned integrated and indivisible and balanced its three dimension of sustainable development. So it is the end of the silo approach. And therefore, we are asked by ECOSOC to say, give us some advice how to organize the UN system, because the UN system was always organized from north to south, ever. They never had the chance to say, but you guys in Germany, you make a very bad environment policy, not only, but a sustainable development policy by misusing the capacities and externalizing costs of your well-being. So that was that we made this, I believe, quite successful presentation and work under the title The Future We Want and the UN We Need. And that we have now Amina Mohamed as the Deputy Secretary General responsible for development is a huge step forward. We came to the recommendation that we need cohesion in diversity. And we must overcome the separation. Habitat is for goal 11 and the others that. If we go in this direction, by the way, with all due respect, also in national governments, then we will have a problem. How can we make this really integrated? A national intended contribution to implement the Sustainable Development Goals would be a good chance for the integration approach. We discussed in Germany intensively the architecture for sustainable development. So we have a Deputy Minister's Council for Sustainable Development. They have to be upgraded. Don't believe that after the election we will have a Ministry for Sustainable Development. Never know, but never know whether we have a government, so therefore that is the basic decision. But we have this Deputy Minister's Council, I believe a very important part. We have in Parliament a specific organization for sustainable development, all parties integrated, quite relevant. And we have the Council for Sustainable Development, Rat für nachhaltige Entwicklung. And I can only mention that this is a very, very important instrument, officially installed by the government, but very independent. It must be independent. I was also a deputy chairman there, and therefore must be independent, no doubt. There's no doubt. And we are convinced that this architecture is not yet correct. We have to go further on, especially in the implementation on government and on the different levels of our society. We have Länder, we have communities, and we must make everything possible to integrate those three dimensions in Germany. Therefore, we differentiate implementation of SDGs in Germany, implementation with Germany, and implementation by Germany. By Germany is also to develop green technologies. We are very convinced that the immense investment our consumer of electricity made for the development of renewable energy is a good contribution to implement the sustainable development goals. Because when we started, we had to pay for 1 kilowatt hour of solar PV more than a euro for 1 kilowatt hour. Now you are down to 5 euro cent. And they are in a country like Germany with not more than a little bit more than 1,000 solar hour per year. And if you go then and you have 3,000 solar hours in other countries, especially in Africa, you see that the availability of energy is a precondition for implement, and therefore it is our obligation not to ask only what is the best technology for our structure, but we must ask, is that a technology development able to be globalized? Only this is the topic. If we are doing technologies only for the rich people in the north, we make huge mistakes. And therefore, I believe in, with, and by. And I sincerely hope that we take it serious. To give you a little bit of feeling what is going on with regard to those targets and timetables, I only want to add 2 minutes. I'm angry that I'm the blocking person for your celebration. I learned in the invitation there is wine and buffet and live music, and then here's the old man speaking too long. This is difficult. But I go to goal number 11, not by chance, but being here in Vienna. That's the goal: make cities and human settlements inclusive, safe, resilient, and sustainable. That's the title. This goal has altogether 10 targets. 10. I give you a little bit, 2 examples from those 11. 11.1 is by 2030 ensure access for all to adequate, safe, and affordable housing and basic services and upgrade slums. Indicator: proportion of urban population living in slums, informal settlements, or inadequate housing. Only to mention, in the MDGs, we also had the topic slums. In those cases, we calculated with something like 800 million slum dwellers. Right now, after quite a successful development time with the MDGs, we have 830 million slum dwellers. You must be very aware that this is very difficult to quantify as well. If I go back to Nairobi and ask where are inadequate housing and who knows who is all living there, it's very difficult. Therefore, it is only the quantification. If you go to 11.6, by 2030, reduce the adverse per capita environment impact of cities, including by paying special attention to air quality and municipal and other waste management. Indicator: percentage of urban solid waste regularly collected and with adequate final discharge with regards to the total waste generated by the city. Is that the right indicator? We are working intensively that we want to have a circular economy, and that is a totally linear thinking. I would ask much more, what is the percentage of the waste generated to be recycled or being avoided? Only to say it is collected is a very noble dimension. But in Germany, that is not enough, by far not. And we hope that we can close all the cycles. A society with no CO2 emissions cannot be a linear economy. It's impossible. You must have a circular economy. Where is this integrated here? Only one little advance. Therefore, I'm very, very sure that it is necessary to have such an instrument bottom up to ask what is the possibility to reach those targets. And by the way, it is also very, very relevant to make this integrated in the whole society. That is more or less also goal 17 and others. Participation not as a participation at the end of the decision making, but integrated in the decision making. You know, we had a very difficult time in Germany with regard to the use of nuclear power. Now we decided, and was happy that I was chair of the ethics commission, to coming to this decision. We decided to phase out nuclear, but that was not the end of the story. Now you have waste. Now we have waste. And exactly, you see that the linear discussion presents you later with big problems. And that we have to integrate it from the very beginning. If we want to come to a development which is able to handle 10 million people on this globe, we must come to a circular thinking. We must close the wastewater circle, without any doubt. We have the wrong technology in this field because we are using water, which is very scarce resources in other places, and we have a lot of energy to pay for producing and for transporting this water in the sewage water treatment plant, knowing that you need a lot of energy again to clean it. Why can we not do it the other way around, decentralized? Why is it not possible? All these topics are not solved, but they are our obligation to ask, how do you do it now? Can we cooperate with you in doing this? Where are we still linear thinking, consumption pattern, production pattern, very clear? And it is far from having a sustainable Germany. Most probably not so far in Austria, it's much better. But nevertheless, I have to mention that the Sustainable Development Goals need these implementation consideration. And the final wording, the success we got in climate is to a high degree linked with the success of IPCC, the integration of science and politics. Is there anybody here considering, can we have something like an IPCC thinking for the SDGs as well? Is there a chance to do something like this? How can we bring science in the implementation on a broad scale? This I want to give you as your homework. I'm sure that you will do it. And unluckily, I will be not able to come to your 60th anniversary, but then you can present, yes, we have a wonderful integration of science in the implementation of the Agenda 2030. Congratulations for the first 50 and good wishes for the next 10.